के सोम प्रसाद, सोम प्रसाद जी।
थैंक यू सर
जी।
माय फर्स्ट
चार मिनट आपके लिए हैं, आप बोलिए।
पार्डन,
आप बोलिए। फोर मिनट्स।
ओके, माय फर्स्ट अपील टू द गवर्नमेंट इज दैट मोर मनी शुड बी एलोकेटेड टू दिस पब्लिक हेल्थ केयर सिस्टम। नाउ द मनी एलोकेटेड टू दिस सिस्टम इज नॉट सफिशिएंट, इट इज वेरी मीगर। Actually, it disappointed the people who are interested in the healthcare system. That we know that India is a country having more than 130 crore people. Most of them are very poor. They are living in a very poverty condition with a very low income. They depend on the public health system. Now it is only a very meager enhancement in the budget allocation for the whole healthcare system. The government should give more attention to this sector. Sir, in the last month, the media was full of news of the death of children in Muzaffarpur and other parts of the country. These incidents reveals that a naked truth, that the people, poor people, those are sizable number in Indian population, are not financially capable for the service in private health sector. They always depends government hospitals. They have no other choice, sir. So the public health care system should be improved. More money should be pumped for the infrastructure development and for the expansion of the system to the bottom level. It is well known that India is a pluralistic medical care with a well-documented history and a practice of alternative medical form: Ayurveda, Yoga, Unani, Naturopathy, Siddha, and Homeopathy are the integral part of our medical care system. The formation of Ayush department is a very good decision of the government, but the follow-up action and allotment of sufficient fund are also necessary, sir. The development of Ayush is fully depend upon the government attitude. Ayurveda is a science of life with a holistic approach to health and personalized medicine. It is one of the oldest medical system in India. It has more than 500 years of tradition. Ayurveda has the ability to treat many chronic diseases such as cancer, diabetes, arthritis, asthma, etc. Unfortunately, due to the lack of scientific validation in various concepts, the precious gift from our ancestors is trailing. Hence, the evidence-based research is highly needed for the global recognition and acceptance of Ayurveda. According to World Health Organization, about 70-80% of the world population rely on non-conventional medicines, mainly on herbal sources in their healthcare. The side effects of the synthetic medicines, lack of curative treatment for several chronic diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, the unaffordable high cost of new drugs, etc., attract the people to alternate traditional medicines and treatments. Currently, global population is widely accepting the Ayurvedic medicine as the plant-based treatment that can rescue the patients from adverse side effects of the Western medicine. Sir, the government should prepare a time frame roadmap for the progressive development of Ayurvedic education and research. Science-based approach may be promoted, utilized, and in the education, Ayurveda traditional. Sir, one more minute.
Yeah.
Moreover, Ayurveda is continuously facing constraints and difficulties from regulating authorities and scientific community, which is coming in the way of global acceptance. Available literature on the use of Ayurveda for the treatment of diseases is not still evidence-based. There is need for the evidence-based researches in the area to make literature adequate. Western or modern medicine introduced in Asian countries.
Please conclude. Time is over.
Sir, the government should
one sentence.
Allocate more money for the research. That is my main point, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.